Everything in this world is made up of matter. And those matters behave with each other in certain ways. And that, students, is chemistry.
The third-person effect is defined as the perception that the media has a stronger influence on others than it does on yourself. This is not only relevant in the digital era we are living in, as this theory was developed by sociologist Davison in the 80s, when the media were limited to newspapers and television. Let me show you with an example. Emma and Lisa are talking about a popular influencer while looking at one of her photos on Instagram.
I like her dress.
You always copy her style because you're easily influenced by what she promotes in her photos. Well, I'm not.
The next day, Lisa ends up buying the dress that the influencer was wearing, meaning that, although she didn't believe so, she was also influenced by media messages. Meanwhile, many other people are all thinking the same thing. That's to say that they are less susceptible to the influence of the media compared to others, but deep down, they all are.
Now that you know what the third-person effect is, why does it happen? Well, one of the reasons is a mechanism called self-enhancement, where your brain protects you by making you think you're superior to maintain a positive self-view. Therefore, you feel like you're less affected by media persuasion than others.
The third-person effect is a phenomenon that can't really be avoided. Sometimes it's less amplified, for example, when it involves stories that don't affect you personally.
If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends.
Are you interested in knowing more about living online during the pandemic? Then go visit our blog.
You can also find us on Instagram.